page 100. We'll start on page 99b, 20 lines from the bottom of the page. חמש שורות מהרחבות השניות. Anyway, today is a fascinating daf. Today we're going to deal with the value and the importance of studying, learning and teaching Torah, the reward for that. We're going to learn the value of certain scrolls and the sanctity, especially scrolls like the Scroll of Esther. We're going to deal with the books that outer books of the world of Torah, the different attributes and attitudes to those external books and more. Excuse me, let's start. אמר רבי לקס, רבי אלכסנדרי, כל העוסק בתורה לשמה, עושה שלום בפמליה של מעלה ובפמליה של מטה. So here we talk about the importance of one should engage in study of Torah. So as the Rabbeinu Bachya ibn Pekuda in the Duty of the Hearts explained to us, in 9th century great Sephardic judge and rabbi, he explained that there is a two different levels, one who does thing out of fear, one does thing out of love. So here, if someone does something out of fear, that's a different story. The Rambam in Hilchot Teshuvah chapter 10, and it's a different category. Or someone who study in order to get recognition, to feel above others, to teach, just to know wisdom of something. But the idea is lishma is really for this, for own sake. So you bring peace between heaven and earth. It's protections and more. It reminds me when I was a rabbi in Annapolis, Maryland for almost 15 years. I went once to the well-known rabbi in Baltimore, one of the luminary rabbis at that time. And they predicted a huge, almost hurricane, great flood in the whole capital of Maryland. And the rabbi said to me, are you teaching Daf Yomi? And I just started at that time. That was the previous cycle. And he said, tell your balabatim, tell your people, as long as you're engaged in study, and we are the only daily minyan there for so many years. He said, don't worry, everything will be all right. And he was right. So anyway, he said, שנאמר, או יחזק במעוזי יעשה שלום לי, שלום יעשה לי. So because the pasuk, the sentence in Isaiah 27 repeats the same notion twice, or let him take hold of my stronghold, that he may make peace with me, and he shall make peace with me. So why need to repeat it? So here we talk about two different categories, one above, one below. It's a correlation. That's what we said at the end of the prayer, the end of Kaddish. We step backward, or at the end of the Amidah, we said, Oseh shalom bimromav, may one who make peace in heaven will make peace upon hearts. So the Chatam Sofer, the great rabbi in Hungary, the past generation, asked a question. If you look at the structure of the Amidah prayer, we have 19 blessings, and Sim shalom, bring peace, it's the last one. How come? So he explained beautifully, and he said, it's a structure that build up. We ask first for forgiveness, wisdom, healing, and more, and repentance, and very end. Then, after we well behave, then it's a ask for peace. Rav Amar, Kilu bana patlatrin shel mala veshel mata shenamar vasim dvarai beficha ubetzel ki yadi kisiticha. Linto Hashamayim velisod aretz. So here you have two entities. One is Linto Hashamayim, the other one is Lisod Aretz. So since it's the two foundations, one is the heaven, one is the earth, one who has the word of God placed in his mouth through Torah study has established in our language heaven and earth. One of the Hasidic stories, it's about the Rabbi of Kotsk. He said, the son of the Rebbe of Biale was the great author of Avnei Nezer, which is one of the luminary books in the study Talmud and Talmud commentary. So he said the merit, the zchut, was because his father, during Purim, usually people occupy themselves with other things, he sat and study, and since we believe that the whole world survived because of that, so he reached this merit to have a privilege to have the son who's the Abdinezer. There's a two version, either Rabbi Yochanan Amar or his brother-in-law Reish Lakish. Anyway, Af Megen al Kol Olam Kulo Shnemar Betzel Yadi Kisiticha. That's fascinating and it's important. He says that the Torah, one who engages in study Torah, protect the entire world. And this just depends upon our faith. We have to believe that that's basically the protection. Amar Reish Lakish Kol Malamed Bnei Chaviro Torah Malala B'Kitov Kilo Asaro Shnemar B'Tei Nefesh Asur Yatzu B'Chan. They said about Abraham and Sarah that they, in a way, convert or bring people to Judaism. So even they have no children at that time, v'eta nefesh asher asu, all those souls that they bring from Haran. So someone who teach other fellow Torah, it's like he himself born to this world. It's one of the famous tale about the Rabbi Yaakov of Duvna, the Magid. They said that when he reached Shamayim, when he reached heaven, so they show him one time hundreds of books. And he doesn't understand because he never wrote the book. So they said that he took an orphan child and taught him and took care of him. And he became one of the luminary rabbis, which his name is Rabbi Shlomo Kluger. And he wrote extensively a lot of books. So the merit was upon his teacher, which is the Magid of Duvna. Rabbi Lazar Omer, Kilo Asan Divrei Torah, Shilmar Ushmartem Et Avivrei HaBrit Hazot Va'asitem Otam. So it's the Marsha explained, it's like you made it. Rava Amar, Kilo Asao La'atzmo, Shenemar, Va'asitem Otam, Tikri Otam, Ela Atem. So don't look at as they, you shall fashion them, rather you should said Atem, meaning you do it. So the Baal HaTurim, he brings the Midrash, Rabbeinu Yaakov. Said in Parashat Pinchas, you see all the list of the Korbanot, the sacrificial offering. And each of them it's written Vehikravtem, Vehikravtem. We have here a Torah reader, right? Vehikravtem, Vehikravtem in Parashat Pinchas. There's only one time in Rosh Hashanah, there is a different. It's written there Va'asitem Ola. So why? So he said, in Rosh Hashanah, a person stands Keilu Korban, is like himself, is like an offering. So he said the same here, Hamlamedet Ben Chaverot Torah, if someone teach the son of his fellow Torah, Keilu Yetzaro Asao, like he himself. It's a well-known tale about the last Lubavitcher Rebbe, may he rest in peace, that even he himself never had the children by himself, but he have, if not thousands, maybe tens of thousands, students and the people that make the world so special and so beautiful because of those who are not biologically, but in reality, his children, his followers. Amar Rabbi Abahu kol ha-maaset chaviro lidvar mitzvah malah alav ha-ketuv kilu ha-asah shenemar ומתחה אשר הקית בו את היור וכי משה יקאו ועל אהרון יקאו אלא לומר לך כל המעשה חברו לדבר המצווה מלאה וכתוב כאילו ההסעה. So the story about the Chazon Ish in Bnei Brak, one of the most well affluent business person, said to him, I want to retire and I want to sit and study. He said to him, no, keep your business and just support more and more Torah people and Torah institution. And he brought the source from this Gemara. So we learned yesterday in a brighter Apikoros, Rabbi Rabbi Chanina Amri Tarbayu Zeh Mevazet Hamid Racham. What exactly Apikoros? Someone who's put down or treated to a scholar with contempt. Rabbi Yochanan and Rabbi Shua ben Levi Amru Zeh Mevazet Chavero Bifnei Tamid Racham. Another option is the one who treat another with contempt before to a scholar. So. Otherwise, he have the kind of respect that he will not do such a thing. Bishlama leman de'amar ha-mevazeh chavero b'fnei talmid chacham. Epikoros ha-ve, mevazeh talmid chacham עצמו מגלה פנים בתורה שלו כהלכה. So they said, leman de'amar mevazeh talmid chacham זה אפיקורוס ה-ve, מגלים פנים בתורה כגון. מהי כגון מנשה בן חזקיה? So unfortunately, Menashe ben Chizkiah, we learned in the previous daf that unfortunately he have his own ideas and also flawed idea about Moses, the Torah, and a lot of things that was wrong. There is a book called Beit Shmuel, the last one, Beit Shmuel Acharon. He wrote about the ethics, the Pirkei Avot. We learn the Pirkei Avot. Oy lehem labriot me'elbona shel Torah. Wow upon the people that from the insult of Torah. So he said, Almighty Rachamav al kol ma'asav, his compassion upon all creatures. So the Almighty started with money and then continued with the people, with the soul. So he said, only a person receives a special treatment of compassion and mercy if he have a respect of the Torah, but if he's content and denigrate and mock the Torah, the God, in a way, measure for measure, do not show him extra ordinary compassion. And that's a, oh wow, oh you ahlaim labriot, because they do it for themselves, they denigrate the Torah, so therefore, pogah bahem tchila. That's what the Gemara said. Someone haba misha ba'ala visurim, chas v'shalom, if someone have all kind of suffering, yefashpesh b'ma'asav. Im lo matzah, if you couldn't find, itle b'bitul Torah. Anyway, אי ביקר דמת לה סייפה, מגלה פנים בתורה, רב ורבי חנינה אמרה זה המבזה תמיד חכם, רבי יוחנן ורבי יהושע בן לוי אמר זה המבזה את חברו בפני תמיד חכם. בישלמה למד אמר מבזה תמיד חכם עצמו, מגלה פנים בתורה אבי. מבזה חברו בפני תמיד חכם, אפיקורס, אבל למד אמר מבזה חברו בפני תמיד חכם, בגני פנים בתורה אבי. אפיקורס כגון מאי, אמר רבי יוסף גון הנה דאמרי, מה נענו לרבנן, לדידו קרו ולדידו תנו. So it's like mocking Tamid Chachim said they do it for themselves and more. This is one of those famous stories about the Chafetz Chaim, great rabbi of Radin. He came to bless donors for a hospital. Those days people gave 10 beds, 50 beds, so he blessed them. And then it was a great Torah scholar that came in, so he blessed him more than everyone else. So one of the donors asked him how come. He didn't donate beds, he didn't donate 10 or 50 beds. So he said, look, because of his study, because of his Torah, there is no there is a reduction, there is no sick people. Like soon we're going to see about cities of Sodom and Gomorrah. The Almighty said to Abraham, if there are 10 righteous people, meaning if there are 10 people who study Torah, Sodom and Gomorrah will not be destroyed. אמר לי אביי, היי מגלה פנים בתורה, נאמרו כדכתיב, אם לא בריתי יומם בלילה, חוקות שמיים וארץ לא שמתי. So it's the notion that without even a moment of Torah, Nefesh HaChaim said that there is no survivor of the world. So one of the stories about Natsivo Volozhin is that after Yom Kippur, while everyone breaking the fast, he sat and study. And then about an hour later, he turned and he started eating. So everyone asked him, why are you adding more to the fast? He said, it's not, he just drink a little water. But he said, my fear is that since everyone occupied themselves with studies, no one occupied themselves with food, they missing the point that the world cannot survive without Torah. I want to make sure now, when it's hour over, I'm sure that there are other people around the globe that study, so I allow myself to take a full meal. אמר רב נחמן בר יצחק, מאחנה משמע מינה, שנאמר ונסעתי לכל המקום בעבורם, as we said earlier in Bereshit chapter 18, story of Sodom and Gomorrah, when Abraham negotiated with God. So he said, maybe there are 45, 30, 20, then he ends up by asking even there are 10. And so God said, if there are 10 people who study Torah, they atone for the whole. So what exactly the meaning of Apikoros? Ela, kigon diativ kamei rabbi, ve'nafta lishmata beduchtav, amar hane amrin anatam, ve'lo amar achi amar mar. Rude behavior, that someone hears something from his teacher, and instead of saying on behalf of his teacher, he said that he incorporate himself with his teacher and is denigrate the honor of his rabbi. So therefore, that's another type of avikoros. One of the story about Rav Dushinsky in Yerushalayim was a very takif, was a strong man. He wrote extensively. One of his books, he pointed out that his chidushim and his great ideas and understanding and interpretation of the halakha and Talmud was only solely things that he composed independently. But anything he does while he was teaching his class, he felt that he should not take the full credit and it should be also part of the students. So therefore, he didn't publish only thing that he did independently. Rabbi Amar Kegon Hane Devei Binyamin Asiya, that's the house of the, they call him Binyamin the doctor. The Amrei who say, Man ahanei l'rabanan, in what manner have the sages benefited us with all their Torah study? Me'olam, they never. 100 lo shaulan orva velo asulan yona. They're not permitted the raven, nor they have permitted a dove for us. So the Maharsha explained that raven is the siya tuma, is the highest level of ritual impurity. And the whole idea is that they, in one hand, the sons of the Binyamin HaRofe, the doctors, they agree that the whole survival of the world is dependent upon Torah, but they denigrate the value of Torah itself. So nation of Israel is like a dove, the Maharsha explained, that is always considering a pure one. And based on Gemara in Chulin 63, that's the idea that they merely tell us matters stated explicitly in the Torah. Rava Kiavu Maitit Refet Avei Binyamin Kamei, when they brought him a treifa from the house of Binyamin before him, when he will see Kiavu Chaza Beitamelei Tera, when he notice that is a reason to make it terah, because the Gemara in Cholin, at the beginning of the third perek and onward, have a list of 18 mumim, 18 blemishes that can cause an animal to be treif, because eventually it's going to die, etc. Ki haba b'tam al etera amar techezu dekasherin lochu orva. Ki haba chazel tam al isur amar lo techezu dekasan lo yonah. There's a famous story about the Chazon Ish, a couple, childless, and they pray a lot. So eventually they have a baby boy, but he was born at the 8 months. So he was in a critical condition. So the Chazon Ish wrote a special book, his Ma'aracha, that explained all the different halachot involved in the child, an incubator and more. And he said because of that zechut of the Torah, he saved the child. The same story people talk about the Rebbe of Lipschitz. Anyway, Rav Papa Amar, Kigon de Amar, Hani Rabbanan, Rav Papa Ishtalei Ve'amar, Kigon Hani Rabbanan Ve'iti Betanita, because he made such a mistake, he took upon himself a fast day. Levi Bar Shmuel Ve'Ravuna Bar Chiya Avu Kemat Mitakanim Mitpechot Ve'i Sifre De Ve'Rab Yuda. So they use a cover for the sacred books in the yeshiva of Rab Yuda. Kimatu Limgilat Esther Amrei, Ha lo bay mitpachat. So they saw the book of Esther, they felt they don't carry the same level of sanctity, so they didn't bother to have a cover. So they basically fell by themselves and they asked for the consent of Rav Yudah, who was the Rebbe, the Rashi here. But anyway, so they Amar lehu, so he respond to them, ki agavna micheze ki afkeruta. It's like chutzpedik, you don't tell me, you're asking, you don't ask, you just tell me. It's a fact. That's not the proper behavior. That's not the way you should communicate with me. And there is a Gemara in Megillah, page 7, if what's the value of, in a sense, of sanctity of Megillat Esther, if it's metama b'yadayim, not metama b'yadayim, if you need to cover. So it's apparently, it's they try to treat it, Maharsha said and others, not the same sanctity. The Chatam Sofer bring Shelat Yavetz in Chelek Bet Siman Kuf Gimel. He brings this Gemara in Megillah, page 7. He says that if you tell me that Esther Beruach HaKodesh Nemra, so you should treat it the same as Sefer Torah. So he said on behalf of his Rebbe, which was Rabbi Nathan Adler, he said that when he read the Megillah, he treated the Megillah the same as the Sefer Torah. They should not touch it directly. But that there is a different view in halacha when it's come to the Megillah. Anyway, Amar lo ki avnei mechazek ki afurut. Rav Nachman Amar ze akurel rabbo bishmo. One who calls his teacher instead of my holy teacher, my Rebbe, just named. Amar Rabbi Yochanan Temen Nash Gechazi. Why Gechazi? We learn in the Mishnah, page 90. Not reward in the world to come. Neshikana al rabbo. He called Elisha Navi, his teacher, Bishmo, his first name, Shemar, Vamag Yechazi Adni HaMelech, Zoh Isha Shob Nai Shechaya Elisha. So it's disrespectful. People ask, the Gemara in Kiddushin 443, we read about Uchiyah, Uriah, and others that they did it the same. It's a lot, but in general, HaKorel Rabbo Bishmo Nikra Apikores, someone who calls his Rebbe in his straight name, he's considering as an act of Apikorsut. In the book called Moshav Zkenim, he asked, the Torah said in Bamidbar Yudalef that Yeshua said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Adonai Moshe Klaim. So how come he said Adonai Moshe in the first name? So we know the Shulchan Aruch, Yoredea Reish Mem Bet, that one should not call his Rebbe in his first name. But there's a few explanations. Parashat Drachim brings the story of David and Mephibosheth. It's if he said Adoni Moshe, they said here the Shema Torah first, it's okay, Berkei Yosef bring, that's the idea of Adoni Moshe Klahem. The Hagahot that we have at the very end of Shulchan Aruch from Mibal Tshuva Me'ava, so he bring from his Rebbe, another Rabbi Yehuda, who brings Shach, who said that it's like saying that you have another Rebbe, so and disrespectful. But the Sfat Emet explains that Gadol Merabban Shmo, that they have a different category of names. So sometimes the name, like Shmuel and others, is the same as Moshe Rabbeinu. The Moshe is Gadol Merabban Shmo, by using the first name, is the highest respect way. Tativ Rabbi Yirmiyah v'kamei d'Rabbi Zera v'yativ v'kama. So usually the Miglat Margalit Hayam said that it was a certain decorum, this certain way that they speak before the teachers. They have to stand, yativ. Anyway, Atid HaKadosh Baruch Hu Lotzi Nachal Mibet Kodesh HaKodashim V'alav Kol Minei Megadim. The Almighty is going to bring a special river emerge from the Holy of Holies, and alongside it, all sort of delicacy will grow. Why? Because they said, Sheneemar, in Yechezkel 47, V'al HaNachal Yaleh Al Sfato Mizeh Umizeh Kol Etz Ma'achal Lo Yibol Aleh Uv Lo Yitom Piryo Lachad Ashav Yevaker Kimimav Min HaMikdash Hashem HaYotzim V'ayaf Yiro Lemachal V'alo Letrufa. אמר לי אוסבה, אלולי פרסון סד, ישר, וכן אמר רבי יוחנן ישר, אמר לי רבי ירמיה לרבי זרע, כי אגב נע, מי מחזי יפקרותה, אמר לי, היי, דיס, סביו המסייע לי, אלא ישמיע לך, השמיע לך, כי עד יתיב רבי יוחנן וקדריש, עתיד הקדוש ברוך הוא להביא אבנים טובות ומגרליות, שהם 30 על 30 אמות, וחוקק בהם 10 ברום 20, ומעמידם בשערי ירושלים, שנאמר, ושמתי חד קוד, שמשותייך ושערך לבני אקדח וגומר, לגלג עליו אותו תלמיד. So the student mocked him and said, now at present we do not find a precious stones comparable to the size of egg of a palm dove, and you will find as large as they, as those you describe. השתה דוויתה דצילצירה ומקשכחנה, כולה היה משכחנה. So how come you tell me that that's going to happen? Look at the punishment. לימים מפליגה ספינתו בים. Sometimes later the student's ship was set sail in the sea, חזינו למחר שרד כמה נסרים אבנים טובות ומגלות. He saw the ministering angels cutting precious stones that side. So there is a few explanations, what does that mean? The Maharal said that it wasn't real, it was just a euphemism. Speak about Yerushalayim in the future or different understanding in the Chochmah. If that literal or not is a big question. Anyway, according to Maharal, is not literal, is a figurative. So anyway, אמר לו הנה למען, אמר הקדוש ברוך הוא להעמיד בשער ירושלים, כי הדר אשכחה לרבי יוחנן, בידתי וכדריש, אמר לי רבי דרוש, ולכן היה לדרוש, כשם שאמרת כך ראיתי, I saw exactly the way you said it. אמר לו ריקה, אם לא ראית לו האמנת, if you don't see it, you don't believe it, you are one who mocks the statement of the sages, מלגלג על דברי חכמים אתה, יאב בעיני ועשהו גל של עצמות, רבי יוחנן, directed his eyes to him in anger and rendered him a pile of bones. So obviously that's a severe Mefarshim said that he took away the Ruach HaKodesh from him. The Gemara in Shabbat in page 30 said that's what we pray every day. Shtatzilenu me'azei panim u'me'azut panim. Meitivei. והולך אתכם קוממיות. Now, Rabbi Yochanan said that the time of the Mashiach, Kadosh Baruch Hu make a special gate to Yerushalayim, they have 20 cubits high. So the Gemara said, the Pasuk said in Vayikra 26, והולך אתכם קוממיות, and make you go in the upright. So he said, רב מאיר אומר, מתי אמר כשתי קומות של אדם הראשון? So that's basically the Adam Rishon, the Gemara in Chagiga 12 said, that's the Pasuk, v'teshad like a pecha, That's the numerical value of the kaf is 20, pe is 80. So that's Rashi explained. The Maharal explained that mea is shleimut. It's like perfect. That's the perfect of the first man. Latid lavo. Anyway. אז אפילו אקספנס רבי יהודה אומר, מאה אמה כנגד איכל וחות עליו, שנאמר אשר בנינו כנדים גדולים גנוריהם, בנותינו כזוויות נכותבות תבנית איכל, כי הקמה רבי יוחנן, לחווי בי זיקה. So the window through which a wind enter, so the gates through which people enter, will extend considerably higher. So Yuni Yaakov said that usually the problem is, why you use it? Because people have an issue of belief. Only that's the reason why you talk only about the ptachim ketanim, the small gate. So now the Gemara go back to the pasuk that Rabbi Yirmiya brings about those trees that will rose at the Sfata Nachal, that the beginning of the rivers that come out of the Holy of Holies. And that's called alehu letrufa, and it will be leaf for medicine. Maiva alehu letrufa. What does that mean? Rabbi Yitzchak bar Avdumi bar Rabbi Chizda achad amar leatir pe shel mala. Which is help those who mute, who cannot speak. Chadamar latir peh shel mata, the woman that cannot have children. So that's Maharal said that that's more figurative. It's not physical. It's the spiritual part and the physical part. The capability of speak that can be in both ways. Itmar nami chizki amar latir peh ilmin, bar kapa amar latir peh akarot. So you see here three different attitudes. Chizkiah hold that is to unlock the mouth of mutes, and Bar Kappara said that to unlock the mouth of barren women. So there's a famous story about a fellow that was a barren child. He have no children. And he went and he davened and he prayed on the Or HaChaim HaKadosh, Rabbeinu Chaim Ben Attar in Har HaZeitim, in Mount Olive in Yerushalayim. And he prayed hard, he asked for a child, and he promised that if he have a baby boy, he will name him after the Tzaddik, after the Or HaChaim HaKadosh. Shortly afterward, he his wife were blessed with a baby boy. Problem is, at that time also his father passed away. So he was torn, how should he name the child? So he went to the Belzer Rebbe, and the Belzer Rebbe said, you can't have both names. He said, you have to understand, you came and davened before the Malach, before almost like ministering angels, because the Or HaChaim HaKadosh is not the level of another fellow, it's very high. So you daven there, you cannot combine al techaber shem adam lemalach. Don't combine a name of your late father, with all the respect, God willing, you have more children, you name it after him, to malach, because bekivro noshata, you went to his grave, and because of his chut, so you have to keep your word and you have to keep the name. Rabbi Yochanan amar litrufa mamash, it's really medicine. Ma litrufa Rabbi Shmuel ben Nachmani amar litoar panim shel baalei hapeh. So the toponym Shbalei HaPeh, so the Maharal explained that that's the Koach HaDibur, the capability of speaking. Darash Rabbi Yehuda Bar Simon, Kol HaMachshir Panav Al Divrei Torah Ba'olam Hazeh. So the idea is that he basically forsake in a way everything else and he focus only on the Torah. HaKadosh Baruch Hu Mahivhig Zivav La'olam HaBa, God reward him with literal face in the world to come. שנאמר מראו כלבנון בחור כארזים. אמר רבי תנחום ברבי אלי, כל המראי בעצמו לדברי תורה בעולם הזה. הקדוש ברוך הוא מסביאו לעולם הבא, שנאמר ירבוין מדי של מדיך המלאך עד עניך תשכם. So obviously that's not just literal, the spiritual as well, that's the way the Maharal take it in Marsha. קהת הרב דימי, רב דימי traveled from ארץ ישראל to Babylon, he said, אמר עתיד הקדוש ברוך הוא ליתן לכל צדיק וצדיק, מלוא אומסו, שנאמר ברוך השם יום יום, יעמוס לנו, הקל ישועתנו סלע. So he quoted Tehillim 62, that said, blessed are you God, he is our salvation, סלע. So basically that's the idea that God reward each and every one of us in that way. I remember my late grandfather was the Zidichoyver Rebbe, he used to sing this song, every Shabbat morning and quoted this Gemara. Amar le Abaye, b'chi efshar lomar ken v'lo כבר נאמר, in Isaiah 40, ממדל בשאלו מים, בשמיים בזרת תיקן, אמר מה איתם הלא שכיחת באגדתא, דאמר במערבה, משמי דרבה בר מר, יתיד הקדוש ברוך הוא ליתן לכל צדיק וצדיק 310 עולמות, שנאמר להנחילו אהבה יש, ואוצרותיהם ימלא, יש גימטריה תלת 110 אבי. So literally meaning that the numerical value, it's a 300, shin is 300, and yud is 10, so that's the the Rambam said that that's just a dimyon, just the imagination to understand what's the reward we have in the world to come. But the Torat Chaim explained that we have 613 mitzvot, and we add to that the Sheva mitzvot de Rabbanan, so we have the 620 mitzvot, and if you split it to two, Ezer Kenegdo, so each one of them gets 310 olamot. That's the idea of Otzrotehem Yemale, that's Ish V'Isha, each of them get 310 olamot. And obviously the Yismach Moshe said it's all depend upon the Madriga, some get olam gadol and some olam katan. Anyway, Tanya Rab Meir Omer B'Midah Sh'Adam Oded Modedim Lo, that's the famous Mishnah, the same as Brachot, that is all measure for measure. Nechtiv B'Sa'asa B'Shelchat Riven, Amar Lo Rabbi Yoshua, God take out Yoshua. וכי אפשר לומר כן, אדם נותן, person give צדקה מלוא ומסו לעני בעולם הזה, הקדוש ברוך הוא נותן לו מלוא ומסו בעולם הבא, והכתיב שמיים בזרת תיקן, ואתה היא אומר כן, איזו היא מידה מרובה, מידה טובה מרובה או מידת פורענות? What is the attribute to the reward greater than the attribute of punishment greater? 100b, הווה אומר מידה טובה, מידה טובה מרובה ממידת פורענות. The attribute of reward is greater than the attribute of punishment. במידה טובה כתיב, היצב שחקים ממעלה ודרכי שמיים ודלתי שמיים פתח, והמטר למען לאכול במידת פורענות אומר, והרבות השמיים נפתחו. So you see here the difference between punishment and reward, obviously, that they open only window when it's come to punishment. God open only window, which is considerably small openings than doors, so it means that that's the attribute of reward is greater. במידת פורענות כתיב, ויצאו וראו פגיעה אנשים פושעים בי כתועלתם לא תמות ואישם לא תכבה והיו דיראון לכל בשר, ולא אדם מושיב אצבעו ברור העולם הזה מיד נכבה לה, כשם שקדוש ברוך הוא כוח ברשעים לקבל פורענותם, כך קדוש ברוך הוא כוח בצדיקים לקבל טובתן. רבי עקיבא אומר, אף הקורא בספרים החיצוניים, זהו חלק לעולם הבא, סובול איזדת מין, תנא בספרי מינים, סמסה בספרי צדוקים, רבי יוסף אמר בספר בן סירנה מאסור למקרי. אמר לה, הבאים, הייתמה, אילמה משום דחתה בלא תנטוש גילדנה מעודני דלא לייזל משקי לחבלה, אלא צלי עתה בנורה וכל בית תרטין גריצין. אם היא פשוטי בורא את הנמי כתב, לא תשחיד את הצו, אם ידרשה אור אחר רק המשמלן דלא לבעול שלא כדרכה. So obviously that's cause pain and discomfort. אלא משום דכתיב, בת לאביה מטמונת שווא מפחדה לא תהיה שם בלילה בקדמותה שמה תתפתה בנערותה שמה תזנה. בגרה שמה לא תנסה, ניסית שמה לא יהיו להבנים, מזכינה שמה תעשה כשפים. הרבנן אמרו, אי אפשר לעולם בלא זכרים ובלא נקבות, אשר מי שבניו זכרים. אוי לא למי שבניו נקבות. אלא משום דכתיב, לא תעיל דוויה בליבך דגברי גיברין קטל דוויה. השלמה אמרה, דאגה בלבי שישכנה. רבי עמי ורבי אסי, אחד אמר, יש שיחנה מדעתו, ואחד אמר, יש שיחנה לאחרים. So basically that's ease. Person anxiety when both agreed that the statement of the Ben Sira vel mishum dechtiv mina rabim mitoch betcha velo akol tavi el betcha v'rabbi nama amara detani rabbi omer l'olam lo yarbe adam reim betoch beto shema shenemar ish reim leitroya ela mishum dechtiv zal dekan kur teman av dekan sachsan dinfach bechasei latzachei amar b'ma yechol lachma lachma sav mineh מיני מי דעית למעברת בדקני כולה עלמה לא יחללי. אומר רב יוסף מין למעליית דעית בי דרשינן לו אישה טובה מתנה טובה בחקר אלוהים תינתן אישה רעה צרעת לבעלה. מי תקנתה גרשנה מביתו והתרפא מצרעתו. אישה יפה אשרי בעלה מספר ימיו כפליים. העלה מניך המשת פחן פן תלחד במצולתה אל תת אצל בעלה למסור עמו יין ושחר כי בתואר אישה יפה רבים מושחתו. ועצומים כל הרוגי הרבים היו פצרי אוכל המרגילים לדבר הערבה, כניצוץ בעיר, כניצוץ מבעיר גחלת ככלוב מלא עוף, כן בתיהם מלאים מרמה, מנה רבים מתוך ביתך ולא הכל תביא לביתך, רבים יהיו דורשי שלומך, גלה סודך לאחד מאלף, משוכבת חיקך שמו פתחי פיך, אל תצר תיצר צרת מחר, כי לא תדע מה ילד יום, שם למחר איננו, מחר מצטער על עולם שאינו שלו. סתגמור יסד כל ימי עני רעים, בן סירה אומר אף לילות, בשפל גגים גגו, ומרום הרים כרמו, ממטר גגים לגגו, מאפר כרמו לכרמים. סימן, זהירה רבה משר שיה חנינה טוביה, ינה יפה יוחנן מרחם, יהושע מקצר. אמר רבי זירה, אמר רב, מה ידכתיב כל ימי עני רעים, אילו בלב תלמוד, וטוב לב משתה תמיד, אילו בלב משנה. סטדי הלכי קונקלוז'נס. And encountered no difficulties. רבא אמר איפכה, ואיינו דאמר רב משר שיהיה משמדי רבא, מה ידכתיב מסיע אבנים מייצב בהם, אלו בעלי משנה ובוקע עצים מסכן בהם, אלו בעלי תלמוד. רבי חנינא אומר כל ימי עניים רעים, זה מי שיש לו אישה רעה, וטוב לב משתה תמיד זה שיש לו אישה טובה. רבי ינאי אומר כל ימי עניים רעים זה איסטניס, וטוב לב משתה תמיד זה שתעדו יפה. רבי יוחנן אמר כל ימי עניים רעים זה רחמני, וטוב לב משתה תמיד זה אכזרי. רבי שמעון לוי אמר כל ימי עניים רעים זה שדעתו קצרה, 101, שדעתו קצרה, is intolerance, is short, וטוב למשתה תמיד זה שדעתו רחבה. ואמר רבי שמעון בן לוי, כל ימי עניים רעים, והעיקר שבתות והם טובים, כדי שמואל, דמר שמואל, שינוי וסת, תחילת חולי מאיים. תנו רבנן, קורא פסוק של שיר השירים ועושה אותו כמין זמר, והקורא פסוק מבית משתאות בלא זמנו, מביא רעה לעולם, פני שהתורה חוגרת שק ועומד לפני הקדוש ברוך, ואומר לפניו רבנו של עולם, עשו ניבניך ככינור, שמנגנים בו ליצים. אמר לביתי, בשעה שאוכלים ושותים במה יתעסקו, אמרה לפניו ריבונו של עולם, אם בעלי מקרא הם יעסקו בתורה ובנביאים וכתובים, אם בעלי משנה הם יעסקו במשנה ובהלכות ואגדות, אם בעלי תלמוד הם יעסקו בהלכות פסח בפסח ובהלכות עצרת בעצרת, בהלכות חג בחג. העיד רבי שמעון בן לזר משום רבי שמעון בן חנניה, כל רגע פסוק בזמנו מביא טובה לעולם, שנאמר ודבר בעיתו, מה טוב. והלוחש על המכה, אמר רבי יוחנן, וברוקק בה, לפי שאין מזכירין שם שמיים על הרקיקה. איתמר רב אמר אפילו נגע צרד, רבי חנינא אמר אפילו ויקרא אל משה.